The word for innovation in Chinese is chuangxin. It is composed of two characters, chuang, which means injuries caused by a blade in ancient Chinese, and xin, to fell a tree with an axe. As the two characters imply, the birth of every novelty is accompanied by pains. It requires patience and courage, as well as fantastic ideas, to open up a new path through the forest of science. How do innovative researchers overcome barriers in their work? And what drives them on to do it? Kubuchi Desert in China's Inner Mongolia. Over 20,000 pieces of large equipment are at work here day and night. Every day, they consume over 10,000 tons of raw coal to produce 3,000 tons of synthetic oil and other chemical products. This is the third coal liquefaction plant in China with an annual production of over 1 million tons. How to maximize its benefits is now the subject of discussion. For China, a country rich in coal but lacking in oil, turning coal into oil is a useful solution to boost energy security. The only problem is, how? As early as 1923, German chemists Emil Fischer and Hans Tropik invented the Fischer-Tropik process. This turned raw coal into carbon oxides and oxygen, which, after being purified, can be synthesized under high temperature and pressure using a catalyzer to produce oil and other chemical byproducts.
我们只是从公开资料看一看，真正去看人家不缺告诉你啊，这都是高度绝密的东西，也不可能告诉你太多。实际上，有些核心技术真正对安全、对国家有很重要的东西，它是不流动的，也是总书记讲，你是要不来也买不来也讨不来的。能够掌握咱们自己的手中，不被别人掐脖子，这个很关键。但是这个很多事情确实它需要长期的积累，它不是一个一蹴而就的一个事情。 所以我们呢，既要鼓励科学家呢大胆的创新、自由的探索，同时呢，我们社会也要有这个一种包容失败的这样一个氛围，那使得科学家才能够更多的去敢于去创新、敢于失败。
On a chilly winter's night in Belgium in 1997, the then 35-year-old Dr. Li Yongwang received a telegram from China. Learning that the Chinese government had decided to develop its own coal liquefaction technology, Li returned home. That was before he realized that a long and arduous journey still lay before him.
要数据没数据，要资料没资料，要设备没设备，整个队伍已经处于散摊的状态。他们说做不成，技术难度太大，再一个的话成本太高，可以说基本是从零开始。 不管是总管嘛，上面加
管理局总量的做法，
总量
是它的装置上总量。
Unsurprisingly, Lee met a major problem immediately after the project started: the catalyzer.
就和咱们那个阀面计时的，你不加那头发不了面是一样的，这个油就合不成。所以那个催化剂是一个核心的一个材料。我们大概有五六个这个回工人员在这里天天就研究这几件事儿，为了这个催化剂，每年都要做一次实验，所以一到两个月时间能给200多号人。这个过程非常漫长的，那也失败了无数次。11年，97年开始，一直到08年才成了一个催化剂。
Lee Yongwang and his team have continued to overcome one difficulty after another.The team has expanded to over 1,000 personnel. In 2009, a production line with an annual output of 160,000 tons went into operation. China finally had an independent grasp on the technology. In the meantime, it had been negotiating with a South African company for the necessary technology.But had not been able to reach an agreement on price.
当时定的就是成套眼镜，由于我们做完了，做完了以后和国外的也比较，就比国外的指标先进的多，才决定不用国外的，我们上的。
Since then, the coal liquefaction programs in China have adopted wholly domestically developed technologies.
科研创新这个东西，实施任何东西，你只要脚踏实地，总能做出来很新的东西。看似老的东西，过去的认识肯定不到位。你把新的手段、新的基础理论用上，你就会有突破。
Looking back on the 20th century, it could be a watershed in human history. In 1947.The Nokia Bell Labs in the United States invented the semiconductor. In due course, this enabled the profound technological revolution which shapes the world today. Today, we live in a kingdom of integrated circuits. Change comes faster and faster. In 1965, Gordon Moore, founder of Intel,described in 3 pages a law now named after him, predicting that every 18 months the number of transistors in a chip, along with its performance, would double, while the price would halve. For the following 54 years, this law held true. The problem is that the physical limitations of the chips are drawing near.How to surpass Moore's law is now an urgent priority for chip researchers. Some of them, under Dong Yue Min, are trying to solve the problem with new materials.
上面有一层很薄的这样的一个半导体材料，那么中间呢有一层也是一层比较薄的绝缘层，然后呢再跟硅衬体结合在一起，通过非常这个巧妙的办法，这样的话就形成一种三明治的结构。
The raw material for a chip is just sand. Extract high-purity silicon to make wafers like disks. Then slice wafers to make integrated circuits, and then you have a chip. The smaller a chip is, the stronger its performance will be. But if you want to improve the performance of chips generally, you need more than miniaturization.
很多芯片是单一功能的，原来都是一个一个芯片单独做的，现在多芯片集成在一起，那这样子的话就是综合的芯片的性能就会比较大的提升。
Dong Yue Min's team uses common silicon slices for the lower sheet and bonds them to other materials to make sandwich-like silicon slices. But there are no common sandwiches.There is no gap between different sheets. Besides, the sandwich needs to be extremely homogeneous.
它表面呢非常的光滑，非常的平整，也没有这个凸起，没有这个缺陷。打个比方，就是说这个飞机从法国飞到上海，这个距离它在飞行的过程当中上下颠簸不能超过1.5厘米，那这样的一个平整度的控制。
In fact, this team started developing high-performance silicon materials over 30 years ago. It is thanks to the efforts of generations of researchers that the chip is finally in mass production. But giant challenges remain.There is a long way to go to advance China's chip technology overall.
5G, 未来还有 6G, 它对很多这种芯片的性能要求是越来越高。那么光靠芯片的设计呢，很难满足这个要求。所以说要综合从芯片设计、工艺，包括这种材料的创新，是一个综合的方案来提升，来达到更高的性能，来满足人们对这个速度啊、存储的容量啊、待机的时间，是一种无止境的这种需求。
In 1957, Fairchild Semiconductor was founded by 8 American prodigies, all under 30, among whom were the founders of IBM and Intel.They developed the world's first integrated circuit, starting a technological race which is still ongoing. In 2018, the revenue of the global semiconductor industry reached $476.7 billion. In such an industry where competition is so fierce, anyone could be out of the game for one mistake.Even unquestionable industry leaders like Intel dare not slacken. Innovation is everything and involves many more things than you might expect. Here in North China's Tianjin,A plant is manufacturing a new type of servers, which, unlike traditional servers, are filled with liquid.
This 服务器整体的功耗接近4000瓦，然后整体的计算性能是53万亿次。这个比较狭窄的空间的话，如果要实现这么高的计算性能、这么高的功率，传统的散热方法根本是做不到的。也就是说，你一开机。
Cooling has long been a tricky problem. Traditional air cooling consumes enormous amount of power. The power consumed annually by big data centers in China amounts to 1.5 times the power generated by the Three Gorges power plants. And 40% of this power goes in cooling.Scientists have located big data centers close to the Arctic Circle or deep in caves. But are there any alternatives?
其实就是泡澡，就是你夏天很热，我把你放到这个水里边，你就凉了嘛。它是通过这个液体呢，直接浸没你的这个芯片或者你的散热器。这个液体呢，我们的沸点非常低，我们沸点大概有50度。这液体呢，一碰到我们这个热源，它就气化了，就冒泡了，相变就是气化嘛。它通过这个气化把热量带走。
First come small bubbles, and then larger ones. It is the bigger bubbles that bring away the heat. Although the interval between the two phases is less than 1 second, it's still unacceptable for servers operating at high speed. The technology will be usable only if the boiling process is so fast that big bubbles can be generated straight away.
通过这种特殊处理啊，做成这个更加利于气化，我们叫强化沸腾，这个是我们一个关键技术，也是我们一个难点。因为这个事儿，我们就走了一个博士，走了一个硕士，就是干不下去了，感觉这我解不了。
After 4 years effort, Zhang Peng's team have turned their vision of liquid cooling into reality.
你看这个一个刀片是2.5个千瓦。 那边的方冷的话，我们一个刀片可能只能做到400瓦或者500瓦。就我这一个机箱，就相当于那边的四个机柜，就是我同样的体积，同样一面墙，我同样这么多柜位，我可以放比风冷要提高10倍到16倍的这么一个服务器。这是一个大趋势，也许3年5年看不到，5年之后、10年之后，可能就大体量全都是这种液冷服务器了。
Behind every technology that we take for granted is a long history of struggle. Those that survive might not be the best, but must be sufficiently capable and the most practically useful. It's never possible to say who will have the last word in the race for innovation.
真正能够胜出的，那一定是少数的。所以这个既是一个机遇，也是个挑战。在关键的时候，他做慢一点，也许慢个1-2个月，那可能就意味着几年的或者十几年的这个努力，可能就很大程度付之东流。
基础的方面，就像个树根似的，上面你再扎树枝啊，可以化成一个大树结很多果，但是都是从种子开始的，就那个种子最重要。
Basic research is the key on which all innovation depends.It can encompass endless opportunities and possibilities, even the ability to define the future. It's the great dream of all science. This is no computer animation.It's footage shot by a super high-speed camera. Now, by using nanotechnology, researchers can control the shape of a drop of liquid at will.
普通的水滴落在固体表面，一种是弹跳，一种是溅射开。但是这样一个非常奇特的现象，它可以旋转起来，这个是以前从来没有发现过的。
To control the water drop,Song Yin Lin has been immersed in the nano-micro world for 2 decades. He was drawn to the subject for a completely different reason.
2000年左右，那么当时的墨水和墨盒的价格都是非常昂贵的，这个一墨盒卖100多人民币。那当时我们就做了863的一个课题，就希望开发出这个有自主知识产权的这个墨水和墨盒。
Thus, Song Yin Lin was introduced to the printing industry and became fascinated by it. Traditional stereotype plate making technology is subtractive, removing surplus blanks and leaving the rest to form characters or patterns. This produces a large amount of waste liquid and material. It wastes resources and causes pollution. As an industry outsider,Song had an inspired solution.
因为当时这个数码相机都已经出现，那我们就想，有没有可能像数码照相代替胶卷照相一样，直接打印出这样一个印刷的板，不用原来的曝光处理的过程。
The idea was completely new, but there is no way that stereotype plate making could simply model itself on digital cameras.So Song began to study the basic principles of ink drops. It took him 10 years of lab work. After the technological parameters were established, applications soon followed. Nowadays, many print businesses, including Xinhua Printing, have adopted nano green printing technologies.
就是在一个亲水的板上打出亲油的图案，这个图案能沾油墨，空白区亲水不沾油墨，这样直接就可以印刷了。比如荷叶，以前大家认为荷叶上是印不上字的，那我通过特殊的表面处理就可以在荷叶上印上字去，所以这就造成了我们想让它沾就沾，不想让它沾就不沾，这样就是印刷的整个原理就是这样的。
In contrast with traditional stereotype plate making,Song Yanlin's method does not produce any waste liquid. Beyond that, it reduces energy consumption by 80%. But that's only a first step for Song, who believes that ink drop control technologies can have more amazing applications.
就像印报纸一样，这个电视机、手机、各种电路板都可以印刷出来。但是这里边有非常大的挑战，因为在电子器件里面有很多印刷的精度比传统的印书印报要求高得多，它要求你的这个分辨率要达到纳米的精度，那传统的印刷技术是完全达不到这样一个精度的。
To print the smallest point, the thinnest lines and surfaces, and the most precise solids, Song's team has been at the cutting edge of the global technology for the last decade.
看起来很简单，其实有里边有很多很复杂的、很难的科学的问题，几十年、上百年的难题，每一个过程都需要很多长期的艰苦的研究。但是我们觉得这个事情是，它是很有意义的。纳米导电的墨水就直接打印上去，这一条线就可以做电线用，打印出这样一个导电的图案，这样直接就可以做电路板使用。
Although more work is needed, Song Yin Lin believes that green printing will have wider applications in the near future.
也许将来有一天，我们整个这个手机、电脑跟这个电视机。都是通过印刷的一个一个薄膜，最后把这些薄膜叠在一起，最后就变成一个电视机或者电脑，直接拎起来卷起来就走了。
Revolutionary changes are rare. When they do occur, they are usually results of long-term daily effort. All wonders are the fruits of detailed investigation. Patience and persistence are the essentials.It is the accumulation of such research that makes progress possible. The innovative spirit of our scientists is what enables every industry and every nation to break through the barriers and move forward.